गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. आर टूडेज क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ड्यूरेशन ऑफ बॉन्ड और बॉन्ड ड्यूरेशन. सो बिफोर सॉल्विंग दिस प्रॉब्लम लेट अस नाउ अंडरस्टैंड वॉट एग्जैक्टली ड्यूरेशन ऑफ बॉन्ड इज. द कॉमन वे टू स्टेट इज हाउ मेनी ईयर्स ही और शी हैज टू वेट अंटिल द बॉन्ड मैच्योर्स एंड द प्रिंसिपल मनी इज पेड बैक. दैट वी कॉल इट एज ड्यूरेशन ऑफ बॉन्ड. सो नाउ टू कैलकुलेट दिस ड्यूरेशन ऑफ बॉन्ड वी हैव टू अप्लाई one formula. So I will let you know what exactly that formula is. So D is equal to T summation of T equal to 1 PV into bracket C T bracket close into T divided by P naught, where D is equal to duration of bond, C T is equal to cash flow, T is equal to number of years, PV is equal to present value of the cash flow, P naught is equal to sum of the present value of cash flow. So let us now understand this duration of bond with the help of one example. So example 1, that is calculate the duration of the bond A and bond B with 7% and 8% coupons having maturity period of 4 years. Full stop. The face value is rupees 1000. Both the bonds are currently yielding 6%. So to solve this, we have to separately solve these two bonds solution. So now I will solve bond A, then I will solve bond B. So this is a solution of bond A. So we have to draw these columns. So year, cash flow, that is CT, present value, that is PV, CT into PV, CV, PV into CT divided by P naught, PV into CT divided by P naught into T. So we have to draw these columns. So in year column, as they have given in the problem 4 years, so we have to write 1, 2, 3, 4 years. So in cash flow, that is CT column, 70%, how it has arrived. This now we are solving bond A. So for bond A, they have given 7%. So for bond B, they have given 8%. So now we are solving bond A. So 7% of this 1000. So 7% of 1000 is 70. For second year, again, it is 70. For third year, it is again 70. For fourth year, 1000 plus 70. So 1070 for fourth year. So present value. Okay, a present value PV at 6%. So for both the bonds, they have given 6% yielding. So we have to calculate present value factor at 6%. So these values, it is available in present value factor table. So we have to take or consider that table and we have to take values from that table. So for first year it is 0.9434, for second year it is 0.8900, for third year it is 0.8396, for fourth year it is 0.7921. so we have to take these values from that present value factor table. So now we have to multiply these cash flow, that is CT, into these present value factor table. So we will arrive at these following values. So that is 66.038 for first year, 70 into 0.9434, it will come 66.038. For second year, 70 into 0.8900, it will come 62.300. So for third year, that is 70 into 0.8396, it comes 58.772. for fourth year, 1070 into 0.7921, it comes to 847.547. so if we add this CT into PV, we will arrive P naught. So P naught is equal to 1034.657. okay, so now PV into CT, so this column divided by this value. So one by one we have to calculate. So here I am calculating for first year, 66.038 divided by 1034.657, so it will come 0.0638. for second year, 62.300 divided by 1034.657, it comes to how much? 0.0602. for third year, 58.772 divided by 1034.657, so it comes to how much? It comes to 0.5680. for fourth year, 847.547 divided by 1034.657. It comes to how much? It comes to 0.8192. So now we have to calculate last column, that is PV into CT divided by P naught into T. So in the sense, this column into year column. So one by one we have to calculate this 0.0638 into 1, that is 0.0638. For second year, 0.0602 into 2, it comes to 0.1204. For third year, 0.5680 into 3, it comes to 0.1704. For fourth year, 0.8192 into 4, it comes to 3.2764. If we add all duration of bond, it will come 3.6310. This is for bond A. So same we have to solve it for bond B. So now I will show you bond B solution. Okay. So now again same column we have to draw here. So here again it is 4 year we have to draw. Then again so cash flow, that is CT, here it will come 80 rupees. How it will come 80? I will show you. See, just you refer this 8% into 1000. 8% into, okay, here what will happen? So in a bond B they have given 8% here. So this 8% we have to multiply it by this 1000. So it comes to how much? It comes to 80. So for first year it is 80, for second year again it is 80, for third year again it is 80, for fourth year again it is 1000 plus 80. Why this is 1080? So at the fourth year they will repay back all the installment plus interest. So that is why 1000 plus 80 we have to do. So 1080 will be there for fourth year. So again present value factor at 6%, again we have to calculate it for bond B also. So same value we have written here. It is this values I taken it from one table. Okay, that the present value factor table, I have taken these values. Okay, again CT into PV. CT into PV in the sense, this column into this column we have to multiply. So CT into PV in the sense, 80 into 0.9434, it comes to 75.472. So 80 into 0.8900, it comes to how much? 71.200. For third year, 80 into 0.8396, it comes to 67.168. For fourth year, 1080 into 0.7921, it comes to 855.468. So altogether, it will how much? P naught is equal to 1069.308. Okay. So same procedure we have to follow it for bond B also. So PV into CT divided by P naught. Again, we have to divide these values in divided it by this P naught. So one by one we will do 75.472 divided by 1069.308. So it comes to how much? 0.0706. For second year, 71.200 divided by 1069.308. So it comes to how much? It comes to 0.0666. For third year, 67.168 divided by 1069.308, it comes to how much? It comes to 0.0628. For fourth year, 855.468 divided by 1069.308, it comes to how much? It comes to 0.8000. okay, so we calculated these values. So now we have to multiply these values into respective years. So now we have to calculate this column values. So PV into CT divided by P naught into T, in the sense this value into this year column value. So 0.0706 into 1, it is 0.0706. For second year, 0.0666 into 2, 0.1332. So 0.0628 into 3, 0.1884. For fourth year, 0.8000 into 4, it will come 3.2000. So if we add all this, we will arrive at 3.5922. This is the duration of bond B. So now we will compare both bond A and bond B in this table. So particular bond A and bond B. Face value of bond A is rupees 1000. For B also it is 1000. Coupon rate for bond A is 7%. for bond B is 8%. Years to maturity for bond A is 4 years, for bond B is also 4 years. So McClure's duration, it is nothing but duration of bond A is 3.6310 years, for bond B is 3.5922 years. So now we have to write one comment. So comment I have written, just to refer it. Comment: from the above example, it is clear that the bond with the larger coupon payments has a shorter duration compared to the bond with low coupon rate. So this is the conclusion or comment. Thank you.